Hello, people of the internet. I am Solrak Dragon, and welcome back to Kingdom Hearts 1.5 HD Remix, Final Mix, Proud Mode. And for those of you wondering what took the Fallout 4 video so long, I'm not entirely certain. Anyways, we are back at the end of the world. I went ahead and in between episodes went and got me another Serenity Power, so that is taken care of. And now we can just keep moving forward with the story, because we are very nearly done. Alright. The fact that this thing is a giant flaming pillar and that there's no exit afterwards kind of leads me to believe that this mirror will be a boss of some sort. I know it's going to be the end because we haven't had a little cutscene or anything, so let's head off in. Excuse me there. Whoa. Okay, yep, I was right about being a boss here. Got some physicals and we're in Hollow Bastion now. Hello. Down, everybody. I'm so glad that I'm so freaking powerful right now. We can just go in here. Oh, there's a chest too. Awesome. What do we got in here? Elixir. Okay. Anything further? There's a hole in the very fabric of reality. Yeah, that's not ominous or anything. Okay. Examine this machine, whatever it is. Ones born of the heart of in darkness, devoid of hearts, ravage all worlds and bring desolation. Seize all hearts and consummate the great heart. All hearts to be one, one heart to encompass all. Realize the destiny, the realm of kingdom hearts. The great darkness sealed, the great heart. Progeny of darkness, come back to the eternal darkness. For the heart of light shall unseal the path. Seven hearts, one keyhole, one key to the door. The door of darkness, tied by two keys. The door of darkness to seal the light. None shall pass but shadows, returning to the darkness. Ones born of the heart of darkness, hunger for every heart until the dark door. So is that like official mythology of the Heartless or something and the Kingdom Hearts? I just realized that there's more of these voids in here. Just a little creepy. Can't actually enter that, which is probably a good thing. But we got this giant Heartless symbol here, so we go around it? No. Hello. Hello? Okay, I thought I already checked this out. I checked out that. There's the giant Heartless insignia here. The only other place we can go is back through the void here. Is there anything leaving? Okay, I stand corrected. Now we can't back into that area and there's a gaping hole. I guess I was wrong about that big fiery pit leading to a boss. Well, I guess that's a good thing, because I don't think I was ready for a boss right there so early in the video. Oh, flying. Cutscene. Oh. Oh. Hello. I recognize this music. And I recognize this beast. From multiple sources. The Chernabog. A very, very dangerous monster. In very various mythologies. We're flying to fight him. I think he doesn't have much power whatsoever. Or at least compared to other than the Chernabog. I completely forgot to switch around my magic back when I went for the Serenity Power, I just realized, so I have to throw the gravity. Aroga stuff and Huron. There isn't that bad. At least he's going down fast. And he is nothing compared to Sephiroth. Kind of chicken background to be a little appropriate. But yeah, I recognize this guy. He is originally from the what is it? It's kind of a movie, I suppose. But it's also sort of a animated song, I guess, called Fantasia. Fantasia being the strength up for everybody, and I learned Chernobog falls. But Chernobog was... I'm not sure what the song was, but the whole movie experience is called Fantasia. And there's a sequence, and it's pretty much music that is animated by Disney animators by what they think of the music. And Chernobog was in a sequence with Mickey Mouse. And that's how he's sort of a major Disney figure. Oh, and there's Super Glide as well. And I remember him from that, as well as from Once Upon a Time, because I do watch that show. And it's a good show, too. Definitely check it out. Right, shared abilities is what would be under. Super Glide. Square to fly at high speeds. Hold square to remain afloat. Okay. Not that it's issues to us right now. Are we actually landing in here? Cool. Or no, we're not landing. It's just another zone. Looks. There's a light there. Can I go further down, though? Going down. It looks like we can. Down through the light. Surprising that there's some light in this darkness. Blowing down. But why is this here? I didn't think Halloween Town was consumed. Right, no, this isn't Halloween Town. I don't know what this is. I guess it's just miscellaneous worlds that were consumed, maybe? By the darkness? I guess. Kind of looks like Halloween Town, though, you have to admit. Through the light, again. What do we got next? Oh. Oh! Ow! You, sir, are a jerk! Nope, I didn't want to go back through. Darn it. I forgot that that was there, but I didn't mean to go back through there. Let's try that again. Hello. Ouch. Yeah, yeah, me, Mr. Stompy Stomper said I should probably change my head back. I was about to say, is he even stopped or something? He's not as tough as the other man, actually. He's going down pretty easy. He has less HP than them all, and kind of seems a little smaller. Come on, get down, Sora. Get down, Sora's there. There we go. Arch-Behemoth taken out. Good. Let's quickly change up our abilities real quick, because I don't like having my non-standard build on here. There we go. Oh, I was about to heal up, but I guess I can't anymore. There's that heartless again. Pulsing. And it fell apart. Oh, we gotta kill the enemies in order to break it apart. Okay. That's not too hard, thankfully. Yeah, especially with enemies that take one shot to kill. Wow, I forgot how ridiculously OP you get late game. Even on crowd mode, it seems. Get ridiculously OP in strength. Of course, the invisibles are still... Oh, yeah, another skill. Perfect. I think that is the... I think we can now grab more of the other item. I believe we're just missing the stormy stone. But we'll get that soon enough. Because the enemy that drops it, you know, we have... We're still missing one enemy that dropped the Stormy Stone since none of them here have dropped it yet. Well, we'll encounter that enemy hopefully soon. I'm not sure if it actually spawns in this wave, or if you have to actually clear this. And, yeah, I'll let you guys see when the time comes. Quick. I'm not sure about the other enemy that we're gonna end up fighting though. Come on, man! Oh, I still gotta fight with Shadow Flames. Okay, down. And you can see that the door is slowly being opened. It's not the initial cutscene, it's the only one that showed you it actually starting to fall away. Tank attack with the best of them. Still keep going. No shame in that though. The heartless just wanna get dunked on by the Keyblade Master and see. Come on, Sora, why didn't you jump there? What made Penultimate Junior. Okay, Heartless. I forget how many waves of you there are, but surely your numbers gotta be running low now. I mean, sure you have limitless numbers, but they've gotta be running low, right?
Right.
That last chunk that needs to fall away. We still got an enemy. Nope, but never mind, we don't. Alright, that falls away. And we can now enter that area. So, we'll head right through here. And in here, we have a save point and the final door. Because we are at final rest. So this door right here, it leads to the end boss. So, unless you are ready for the end boss, do not go through there. Especially if you still have items to craft. For now, though... Oh, I missed a chest right there. Of course I did. We didn't get the unique spawn just yet. We got another tail. Very good thing we got it. Let's clear out this heartless spawn. And then... Okay, that was quick. Let's go and see what was inside of that chest. Probably a Mega Elixir or something similarly OP just for the final boss fight that's coming up. I was right, Mega Elixir. Alright. I will be back once we get that unique enemy to spawn here, because otherwise it's just going to be me wasting your time. And these enemies here, they are not affected by the encounter plus thing, I think. So they'll just keep spawning there regardless. And another game. So yeah, another game. I'll be back once I have gotten that unique enemy to spawn. So hopefully, I'll see you guys soon. While not the unique enemy that I had in mind, you can actually get white mushrooms to spawn down here. These white mushrooms will use every single of the white mushroom things. So it's a great place to get the gems of each thing. Anyways, that wasn't where I wanted to show, but when I entered in there, I figured might as well show it since it was an interesting little factoid. Alright, people, I'm back. It took me a little bit of time to get them to spawn, but I finally got them to spawn. And here they are. You might recognize them from Birth by Sleep, but these are the Neo Shadows. Very difficult enemy to get to spawn simply because, well, they are very rare spawn rate, and you have to go 2 rooms away to even have a chance for them to spawn. So in other words, I had to go through that room that I first entered this chamber in, and then up 1 floor. And as you can all see, they have incredible amounts of DR. And they've got different stages to fight depending on how many of them there are. When there's full 7 of them, they just blitz you. When there's 4, I believe, they go into Pop Goes the Weasel sort of stage. And then they go down to that until, like, 2, I want to say. And then from there, one of them will return to stage 1 sort of fighting. And then the other one will go into stage 4 fighting. And when there's only 1 left, he will attempt to summon 4 Neo Shadows. You gotta take them down, though. And they are the ones that drop the Stormy Stone. And we got our Stormy Stone. Woo! That was a long time getting them to spawn. Everybody got, I think, 2 more level ups from all that. Talon is currently lagging behind the most at level 79 compared to Goopy and Mine's level 82. But since we got our Stormy Stone, let's head all the way back, leave the gloom and doom that is the end of the world, to the happiness that is Traverse Town. Yay! Because we do have 2 more items that we can now craft. You might be thinking, well, Solarak Dragon, those are the last 2 items on the synthesis. Usually, your more synthesis ingredient, more synthesis items appear before there's only 2 left. Well, we'll just have to wait and see on that one now, won't we? And for those of you wondering why I'm padding this video out a little bit, it's mainly due to the fact that I want the final boss fight to take up a whole video by itself. Since based off of Birth by Sleep, those episodes can get very long if I don't do that. Hence Ben and Tara's episodes. Let's talk to the Moogle here. We can synthesize us up an EXP bracelet and a ribbon. Alright, and then we'll talk to him a minute. First, let's check out our new equipment here. So, EXP bracelet is not going to be better than anything. Ribbon is reduces all elemental things. So, ribbon and where's the EXP bracelet? Yeah. EXP bracelet, ribbon. It's pretty much not going to replace anything, so I'm only showing this to you guys so you guys know. It does, the EXP bracelet is good for if you want to get more experience, so it can be used for power leveling, but I don't really need to power level, to be honest. The only reason I would even need to is if I want to be level 100 for the end boss, which, I mean, it does sound appealing, and I may very well do that in my off time. I'm not entirely certain yet. Ribbon again. Ribbon and EXP earring. So yeah, nobody can wear either of those. So now we'll talk to the Moogle again, and you can see he's got three new synthesis items. These three are the final three synthesis items in the game. They are Fantasia, a staff for Donald, seven elements, a shield for Goofy, and the Ultima weapon, a keyblade for Sora. All of these have some very, very steep requirements for them. Fantasia, for example, requires Fury, Power, Mithril, and Energy Stones. And for those of you that do not remember, I probably should have gotten this up beforehand, actually. But let's just do that now. Okay, hey, Chwicky. Fantasia. Pop up, there we go. So Fantasia, and why, it's also, oh no, it's that's not Fantasia, it's Fantasista, yeah, that's what it is, Fantasista, but it requires the Fury Stones, which, as you might recall, are dropped by the Gigas Shadow, the Power Stones, which are dropped by the Sniper Wild, the Mithril Stones, which are dropped by the Pot Scorpion, and the Energy Stones, which are dropped by the Stealth Soldier. So, that's that. The seven elements require Blazing Stone, which are dropped by, hang on a minute, let me actually search seven elements. But yeah, you can get an idea that you need the top tier items for everything to even synthesize these. But the Blazing Stone is only dropped by the Chimera Frost Stone, which we thankfully got from the Grand Ghost. The Lightning Stone, which is only dropped by the Black Ballad from Deep Jungle. And then Dazzling Stones, which are only dropped by the Jet Balloon in Neverland, so that's going to be a tough one to get. Finally, the Ultima Weapon. This one, I will admit, has a little bit odder synthesizing things. It requires Thunder Gems for some reason, which, well, you all know how to get Thunder Gems. It's either the Aqua Tanks in Atlantica or doing three Thundagas on a White Mushroom. Mystery Goo, again, dropped by White Mushrooms. Serenity Power, so yay on that. Serenity Power. Gonna have to go through that heck again. Stormy Stone, which I believe we've already had shown, is dropped by the Neo Shadows. Three of them, actually. Lovely. And three Dark Matter. So, yeah, I'm gonna be gathering up some ingredients for quite some time, I imagine. I could go about getting these individually, and I very well might. So, I will come back to you guys when I have all the ingredients required for our final synthesis. Alright everybody, I am back, and while I'm not at Traverse Town and I don't have all the ingredients for the rest of the synthesis left, it did occur to me that there was one thing that I had almost forgotten to do. There's a portal of darkness here now. Pretty sure talking to no. I don't think these three have anything new to say, or do any of them. No, wait, there's an ominous presence behind me, so they do have something new to say. They're sensing an ominous presence coming from there. a gate be a bad omen, and presence coming from that gate, it's another power altogether different from the darkness. So now this enemy up ahead, he is one of the tougher enemies in the game. So you best bring your A game here, folks. Alright. Step through here. We have Beast following us for no apparent reason. And we see a familiar face. Those of you that watched my proof by sleep later at least. Passes right through us. Whoa, I can't read all that. It's too fast. Okay, I can't actually read all that if I pause. If I pause all that, I can read all the dialogue that shows up, but I'm pretty sure it's just things that Aura's said.
Who are you?
Ah, it seems you are special too.
I am Sam?
That name rings familiar. You remind me of him.
What's that supposed to mean?
As I said, familiar foe. Some new tricks. Sora's a badass there. Means you are not whole. You are incomplete. Allow me. To test your strength. Alright everybody, here we go. Round 2 up against Unknown. We want to get out Tinkerbell ASAP before Donald and Goofy go down, because she is invaluable in this fight with her healing capabilities. Alright. I should have probably changed up my item set too, so I would have had a full thing of elixirs, but kind of right now. Back up, and he is not as healthy as Sephiroth, but as you can see, this son of a gun is lightning fast, and he's only got a single blade compared to the unknown that we encountered back in Birth by Sleep, but trust me when I say, it is the same dude. And we never did find out who exactly Unknown was back then either, so I'm not going to spoil that for you. We'll find out before the end of the series, though, trust me. And you can also see that his, while he does not have the health of Sephiroth, he has defenses that are better than Sephiroth. He is affected by gravity magic. That is the only magic he is actually affected by. It does actually stun him for a brief moment, which means he can take advantage and attack. However, he also is, as I said before, he hits hard and he hits fast. And even then, gravity doesn't always slow him down. He can close the gaps with your teleportation trick. I need to bring this back up, and now he's back up to Twin Blade. Such an intense fight this one is. We need to be careful versus him too, because he does have a very devastating special move that I kinda don't want him to get off. And has he actually recovered some health here? I feel like he might have. Oh shoot, he's done, he's doing the special move. Yeah, this is his special move. This is why you want to take. He will seal away your commands. And you have to, much like in the fight versus him in Birth by Sleep, you need to be on the move until you release them. Tink whip down there. Release. Even trying can occasionally become it. But, oh shoot, he's draining us fast. No! Okay, Well then, as you can see, this is gonna be a very, very tough fight. I think I'm going to want to change up my items real fast here. So, yeah, items. Let's give Sora a full batch of elixirs. Stock. I have some elixirs. Yes, I was about to say I have no elixirs, but I do. And exchange for elixirs, Sora. There we go. Full stock of elixirs, because if Donald and Goofy go down in this fight, well, they kind of go down. There's not much you can do to help them from there. Okay, Come on. We can skip this scene since we've already seen it once. Come on, we gotta get out Tinkerbell fast. Come on. Tinkerbell. Okay, got Tinker. That should help us a little bit. Then... can quickly... Oh! It didn't save my changes! I'm without Aroga. I'm without Aroga here. This is very bad. Very bad indeed. Gear up real quick. As I said before, he is completely unaffected by every other match out there, so having Aroga on does not really do much of anything for me. He can't get stunlocked by gravity. Pretty good strategy. It being a little bit much. Or when he locks himself down to attack, it would be a good idea. And while he's locked down, we have gravity because he plays there. Hard Sora, hard fast.
See ya! Heal!
Well, okay, back to Twin Blade. That Twin Blade stage. The real fight begins here. Heal! Okay. Oh, we got him with our gravity break. Thank goodness for that. There we go. Okay, I broke out of it. And I saw two spells here. Good. Up real quick. Force him down. Or up. I didn't manage to force him down, but... oh. Kinda low there. He barely got out of that trap there. Gravity. He's evading like gravity. We can take him down. Sora elixir. We're getting kind of low on that. That's why I do it. There we go. Sometimes it is just beneficial to just spam. The shock does do minimal damage, and if you lose Donald, because I'm pretty sure that's when he goes into that weird mode that just continuously drains you for help. Heal up, Sora. Okay, we need to heal up again. Avoid the shock. I don't know why I'm not getting my trying mana here. I should have max mana, but it's just I broke out of that instantly. Thank goodness there. That probably just saved my bacon, because it looked like it was a little add-on to it where he would have done a continuous drain on my health. Spamming it is a smart strategy, it seems. Yeah, he is a tougher fight than Sora, honestly. just his variety of moves. He may not have the one weight gain attack, but his little locking you down is just as devastating. Not to mention, he is much faster than Sephiroth. Like, by a mile. It's probably why he's only been released in the final mix, he is not an original game enemy. Much like Kirby's undead. I think the fans are kind of an original game enemy. Oh, he's gravity buff. Oh, that gravity break up for him. To avoid this one. This train does not stop. Oh, he's mixing up his attacks now. He's gone into the final stage of this fight, I think, where he does a variety of moves. Take him down. Oh, come on! Break it! Okay, boom. And he has changed from his version in Birth by Sleep, even though Birth by Sleep version technically was made after this version was, I think. His attack damage is going up massively here. I don't know, but let's try it. Nope. He's immune to gravity in this mode. He's gravity immune. He has an anti-gravity field. Oh, come on. I didn't think you could hit me all the way over there. Come on. Break it, Sora. Break it. There we go. We lost Tink, though. We completely lost Tink. Elixir on Donald. Okay, I think the elixir went three. Thankfully. Arcana. You know what? You want to use your fancy move, so will I. Ours Arcana. Oh, that wasn't much of a fancy move there. Oh, Arcana. You want to fight with rapid fire hits? I can fight with rapid fire hits too. Elixir on Sora. One more Arcana. Or Trinity. That's not what I meant to do, but it's going to not even affect me. This mode that breaks things because it's cheap like that. Oh, come on. No! That release changes at the last minute there. Oh, we can do this. We can do this. Alright, I'm back again. No idea how much longer I'm gonna get. Come on, you already lost the tank, unfortunately. She was a very early casualty in this battle. It's very hard to take this guy down. I mean, stupidly hard here. Trinity is kind of the only defense you have against Spears to attack too. And it does do some damage sometimes, other times it does none, and I got a very lucky, I got very lucky there. That should have been the end of me there. Trinity again, why not? Probably end up swinging close. Arcana does more damage overall. Oh, come on, I hate it when he goes into this spear mode. When he goes to spear mode, he cannot touch it. That sucks. Defense up. Arcana. He's almost there. He's almost there. He's so
Fisher!
So we have help. And I'm gonna get in close for our combat. I'm gonna get in close to Zora. Trinity. Might as well give it a shot. And you're gonna have invisible mode. Trinity was away. Oh! He jumped right. Oh! We broke it. No, no, I don't want Trinity. Stop giving me the option of Trinity. Trinity does not help here. When he just goes invincible mode.
Take that!
Come on, Sora. Defense is up. No, don't use Trinity, Sora. I'll cut him. There we go. Almost there, almost there. Come on. Would go in that mode, you would. You're just trying to defend yourself from the inevitable. You can't stop me though. I'm inevitable. Come on, break it, Sora, break it. Come on, Sora. One more shot. Yes! He is down! Oh! That took long enough. Woo! Alright, final cutscene, then I'm gonna end this episode off here. And probably do report section. Wow, Hugh seems to actually have been affected by the fight. Or not. Just like the first time we fought him. Impressive. This will be enjoyable.
What are you talking about?
And he can time freeze. It is beyond your comprehension, for now. Until we meet again.
Wait! What are you-
I am. But a mere shell. Obtain the EXP necklace and Ansem's report number 13 from that. Alright then, like I said, I'm gonna end this episode off here, people. Next time, I'll come back right at the beginning with the synthesis ingredients able to make all the items for these three, and then we can finish off the story of Kingdom Hearts 1.5 HD Remix. So then, I have been Solrak Dragon. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. If you have, leave me some feedback in the form of a like or a comment. If you guys want to check out some more videos by me, be sure to check out my channel. And outside of all that, I will see you all in the next video. Have a fantastic day, everybody. Thank you. Anselm's report, number 8. There is no doubt that the Heartless are deeply connected to people's hearts. Further study may unravel both their motivations and the mystery shrouding the heart. At the start, I built a device that artificially creates Heartless. By recreating the conditions that spawn the Heartless naturally, I should be able to produce them artificially. This device is the culmination of all my research thus far. Machine tests have run successfully, created a Heartless. This may be a step towards creating a heart from nothing. Artificially and naturally created Heartless showed nearly identical traits, but the two types should remain distinct in the experiment. So, I will mark ones that are artificially created. Simply astonishing. Today I had a guest from another world. He is a king, and his vessel is built of the material that composed the medials. He called the pieces Gummy Box. It seems that my opening that door has opened a path to interworld travel. We talked for countless hours, but one story in particular caught my interest, that of a key called the Keyblade. The Keyblade is said to hold phenomenal power. One legend says its wielder saved the world, while another says that he wrought chaos and ruin upon it. I must know what this Keyblade is. A key opens doors. It must be connected to that door I have opened. Just as people have hearts, so do worlds. The same can be said of the stars in the night sky, and deep within each world lies a door to its heart. The Heartless desire those hearts. Born out of the darkness and not people's hearts, they seek to return to a greater heart. Yes, that's it. The Heartless come from people's hearts, as does the darkness. Is the core of the world's heart in the world of the dark Heartless? I pursue the answers there and become all-knowing. My path is set. I shall seek out the wielder of the Keyblade and the princesses. My body is too frail for such a journey, but I must do this. I will cast it off and plunge into the depths of darkness. Opening the door to a world's heart causes it to crumble its walls. These fragments are seen as shooting stars. This explains why these gummy boxes can travel freely to other worlds. I know the catalyst of this collapse, the appearance of the Heartless. However, it will take time to search out the world's doors and to retrieve each heart. Furthermore, the doors can be locked by using a Keyblade, making the heart forever unattainable. I must take action before the wielder of this key appears in this world. If the princesses and the Keyblade are connected, they should resonate. I've chosen a girl. I don't know if she holds the princess's power, but I will find out. She may lead me to the key bearer. I shall set her free and observe. The body is gone. The heart should have returned to the Heartless, and yet nothing. This one is unlike any other. Its memories remain, and has yet to take the form of a Heartless. A close eye must be kept on the situation. Much is still unknown. To get to the realm of darkness, one must go through the door of the Kingdom Hearts, a place where the world's hearts connect. Beyond this world is a place in which darkness reigns. Details shall be archived in a separate report. There are many worlds in existence, some of which we know nothing about. The world in which we live, the realm of darkness, the realm of light, and the world in between, wherein lies true nirvana. Where does the body go when it separates from the heart? If the soul remains within the body, is it still considered to be deceased? When the heart returns to the Heartless, the physical form disappears. That is merely true to this world. Perhaps the body exists in another form, another world. If that is the case, then it is possible for one to exist in two worlds. A being that is neither darkness nor light, belonging nowhere, abandoned by its heart, a mere shell of its former self. This relation between the heart and body is complex. However, I am certain that if your self exists here, then by definition, the other cannot truly exist. The one which should not exist, shall be dubbed